Good morning. Today I'm going to talk about a special way of constructing structures or arches, which is more economic, which is aesthetically pleasing, and which costs less. So my here is the summary of my presentation. I will start asking about artists, the reasoning why we choose artists and structures. So there are many reasoning which governs, which tells us that, yeah, we should use artists. It has also its limitation that to build arts is not that easy, particularly because they are not stable until it meets in the ground. So to solve that problem, there are many techniques, but one of them is use of the concrete fill steel tube. Right? This is fairly new ways of construction technique, but it's very popular in China and slowly using in other countries. So I'll discuss more about why do we build CFSD structures. This, as I mentioned, CFSD is quite popular in China. Many arch bridges, much longer than Sydney Harbour bridges, has been built using this technique. But this type of structure is not common in Australia. We built one small arch bridge using this technique, and whole presentation is about that. I will go through those design, installation, some photographs, and the like. The design and construction of CFST is something a bit unique. There are something technical elements that need to be acutely considered. So I will discuss a bit more on that as well, and I will conclude my presentation with cert conclusion, such recommendation. The picture on the left is the picture on the left is a viaduct, aqueduct in France. This is built in 4080, around 2000 years old. The bridge on the right is a Zhuzhou Bridge in China, which was built in 680. So these structures are still serving, and they are built nearly around 1400 to 2000 years old. So if you ask somebody how long a structure lasts, mostly the designers or construction people or asset engineer or asset managers, they often say 100 years. Here are the structures which have been built and over 2000 years and still serving. Despite all that, in this group, there are so many engineers here, so many designer, and then government, the clients are here. But then how many of you actually think of arches or in your structure? Very few. So this trend has to go away, and because arches last for a long time, and there are a lot of benefits it creates, particularly the not only the longevity it has, but also they are aesthetically pleasing. This is a Queen Elizabeth Bridge in Perth, and this is a Bixby Creek Bridge in US. Try to imagine some different type of bridges on those locations. I don't think any of the other structures would melt with the surroundings so beautifully. So yeah, arches are aesthetically beautiful, and also they take a lot less material, so they're environmentally quite friendly. Because the materials are well optimized in RCS. The another thing is that, you know, as I told you, the structure in the RCS materials are in compression. So we shape the arch such that a large portion of the material members will be in compression, so that the full capacity of the member is well utilized in arches. Unlike beams, for example, the huge compression capacity of the member is not utilized at all, but we are utilizing only the bending capacity of the member. So because of all this usefulness, you know, all these factors, including longevity, aesthetic pleasing, environmentally friendly, the arches has been part of history, economy, and also many a time the items of the national pride. For example, Sydney Harbour Bridge. Who would think when they design a bridge or build a bridge, it would be something of the national significance, the icon or the, for many years, it represents a country. So Arches has that huge potential. Despite all this, the building arts is not easy. This is one of the bridge, 82 meter single span bridge built using the soaring system. You can see the effort you have to put in, the shoring, the framework and everything. It's quite tedious and quite loss of poor energy and resources utilized. Well, thank God that if you apply, the people who design these bridges must have considered the longevity aspects, including the maintenance and renewal. So that's why they win this project. Compared to other type of bridges, they chose arch because you apply everything, then you have the better value, and that's how it's chosen. Otherwise, if you look only the construction as a factor or the direct cost, many a time arches won't be successful. I mean, amongst other types of bridges. So to overcome this difficulty, researchers around the world have been trying many methods, many processes. There are many recent papers has been written about convenient way of construction of the arches. But one of the methods, which is by far most popular and most useful, is concrete filled steel tubular structures. By the name, it says, you know, CFST, concrete filled steel tubular structure. So these structures have some unique phenomena, which works in conjunction with, in line with the principle of arches. As we say in the beginning, forming arch is hard, but with the CFST, you can form the steel tube all around and then form the concrete later on. So what happens with the CFST is that it is, you know, the steel, the portion ratio of steel is almost constant, irrespective of whether the material is in compression or tension or low stress or high stress. But when you're talking about the concrete, its portion ratio is varying. And when the temperature, when the compression goes higher, the portion ratio of the steel concrete become much higher, even sometimes 0.45. So as a result, when a CFST composite is compressed, by the time the concrete inside the tube expand more laterally than the steel. As a result, the expansion attempt of the concrete is stopped by the steel, and the confinement effect occurs, and thus a synergy is produced. So highly efficient material or the composite structure is produced, which has the high axial capacity and more better ductility, and it has a high better performance as a structure. So why do we build CFST? Here is an example. This is a arch bridge in Melbourne, So it's a concrete arch brace, and try to think about building these arches. And you can think about, you can feel the complexity of, you know, producing the formwork, or if you, it is a precast, for example, transportation, connection, developing a joint, and all sort of things comes into your mind. But instead, the one, the photo on the bottom is the CFST arch brace of the similar span. Here you can see the CFST, a thin tube is put from one sore to another, and we pump the concrete, and a massive structure is built with that support. Here on the right, you can see it's a Qinjiang bridge in China. It's 600 meters single span. So the principle is the same. The thin steel tube is put from one side to another, and then we pump the concrete. Just that. So as a result, the steel works as a formwork in the beginning and then become a composite at the end. And as a result, you know, a very efficient construction mechanism, and then the behavior of the structure is produced. So because of this fascinating advantage of the CFST, CFST has been used not only in the arches, but also in many other types of structures where construction is the predominant forces. For example, this is a plaza in Shenzhen, or this is a building in the Fuzhou, China, and this is a subway built in with the CFST in China. You know, a bridge pier, or even for railway bridges. You know, for railway bridges, you know, the vibration or the deformation, it is very critical, and this sort of surface, the arch has been used on that. This is, for example, the single 236 meter single span bridges has been built in the mountainous area. And the advantage of that is, again, it is very easy to transport those little thin tube, and then producing in concrete there is easier than the transporting the heavy precast material on site. This is the Ushan Angji River Bridge, which is 460 meters span. And this is the Hechang number 1 bridge, which is around 530 meters single span. So you can see the beauty it creates. And also, as I mentioned, if you correctly do the proper maintenance in terms of the painting of the steel structure or corrosion protection, then these braces last forever. So despite CFST being quite popular in China, as I mentioned, in China they have their own code about the CFST arch brace code. I was lucky enough to do the research about the shrinkage and creep of the CFST, and which was also part of that code. But you know, for other rest of the world, we use the composite code to design the CFST. The CFST is not quite popular outside China. So with that attempt, you know, with that not being used outside China, so we thought, how about we try in Australia? So we started a very little CFST arch braces, and this is the first CFST arch brace in Australia. One is around 22 meters single span, another is 18 meters single span. So, of course, we didn't just design the CFST to build the first CFST arch brace. We thought of many options and looked under the aesthetic, the longevity, the cost, and other elements. And we came up with one of the options was truss type of structure, and the other type of other structure was CFST, because cable stayed and suspension type of bridges was not considered for the short span bridges. Then we did the analysis.